What do you think the play is here for next week? This is a man, Donald Trump, who stayed away from health care. He doesn't like it being called Trump Care. He didn't want to own it. We remember all that. Now, he says, I'm going to get it done next week. Why would he set himself up with such a clear line of success and failure?
Look, when you're oblivious, when you're Chauncey Gardner, you can say anything and not have to deal with the consequences of it.
You know him. You would really compare. Chauncey Gardner is this movie being aired. It's Peter Sellers. You got to look it up. But the premise is that this guy is an idiot and nobody knows it. And they take everything he says as wisdom.
Right.
This is a smart guy. You know that he knows tactics well.
No.
Why would he do this?
No.
You disagree with my assessment.
I disagree. Yeah. Look, I think he's a real estate savant. He has a good feel for real estate. And when in this city, and it's really a small town when it comes to real estate, you can read the papers, you can listen to the radio, follow some TV, and know what's going on in the real estate market and talk to people in the industry, and you're caught up. That's not the way the world works. That's not the way governing works, and that's a real problem. So when he goes out there and says, this is what I'm going to do, go backwards. How many times has he said, in 30 days, you know, I'm going to have a plan to defeat ISIS. In 90 days, we're going to know exactly what happened with the election and the Russians. 90 days comes and passes, and nobody holds him accountable, or they do, and he just doesn't care. That's being oblivious.
I mean, I was making that point to some of our panelists today about how he made the promise that Mexico was going to pay for the wall. And I keep saying, what happened to that? And everybody laughs because nobody took it seriously. But that was a campaign promise.
There's so many.
And it evaporated.
Look, here's what it comes down to in my mind. Either you believe in the adage that those who don't learn from history are doomed to repeat it, or you don't. And you ask yourself, what is the one topic that President Trump is very literate on, that he really understands and knows well? What's the one thing he knows well?
Marketing, branding.
What's happened to Brand USA? So let's just say, give him that. Give him marketing and branding. What's the next one?
Self-promotion.
Crickets.
Well, hold on a second. Feel. Feel.
Yeah.
Feel.
Media. Star.
I love when they laugh at that.
Feel.
No, he connected with a base that he has no real connection to. You know how hard that is to do in politics?
Campaign. But
it's all identity.
We're not, okay, but I said, what topic? What topic does he understand?
You're saying like academia.
No, just understand.
Economics.
There's certain
stuff like
things.
That?
You guys got all these papers that you read so you can hold a conversation and be learned on a topic.
She actually reads them and it gives me the answers.
It gives you the answers,
I have almost
right?
nothing in front of me.
What does he know? What topic does he know? What is the one topic where you say, you know what, when you talk to President Trump, he knows.
But isn't
this
the Trump report. Card the first word that you just said, President Trump?
Yeah.
I mean, he must know how to do something well. Look where he is.
I think, you know, some people say he started a movement. I think the movement found him. You know, and I'll go back to what my friend said, that he's political chemotherapy for the system.
Yeah, but I mean, I think that you are overlooking his special magic. He has something. He beat out 17 competitors, maybe 18. I don't know how many at this point. He has some special.
Again, he campaigned well. He gave the people what they wanted. He was an entertainer. He was a showman. He never tried to convey that he was an intellect about any topic at all, and that was fine.